Hi everyone, this is Susie. Thank you for joining me today and I hope you're having a great day. When moving to a new location, you want to consider a few important things such as safety, housing options, and activities that you can do there. So whether you're moving to a new country or a new city by yourself, with your family, or with a partner, these are just some of the important things to think about. And so today, I will cover these topics in addition to some practical tips or insider tips sharing from my personal experience after living in Chiang Mai since 2018. At the end of this video, I will also share two of my other favorite places to live here in Thailand and why. Chiang Mai City is the largest city in northern Thailand and the fifth largest in the country in terms of population. But unlike many big cities, there are no tall skyscrapers here or massive buildings. Instead, it's more like a large traditional village that's almost sprawling. Here you can find Lana architecture and interior design in many restaurants, shops, and of course the temples. There are plenty of parks and green spaces, amazing food at inexpensive prices, farmers markets, night markets, shopping malls, a few shopping malls, community events, friendly locals, and gorgeous nature outside of the city. There are so many things to do and places to see, and it's impossible to get bored here in Chiang Mai, whether you're coming here by yourself, with a partner, or with your family. So first, let's talk about safety. Generally, I feel safe here in Chiang Mai, even if it's a relatively large city.
The locals here are friendly, but as with any place you go, be sure to keep your wits and street smarts with you to avoid any issues during your stay. Keep an eye on your valuables, don't leave your keys in your scooter or motorcycle or car. You get the point. There are still some petty crimes happening and some scammers like tuk-tuk scams where you are overcharged, so you need to agree on a price before getting in. And then there's also a motorbike scam. If you rent a motorbike, the renter might find new quote-unquote damages on the bike once you return it and insist that you pay. There's not really such a thing as shady neighborhoods that the traveler should avoid. But petty crimes, if they do occur, take place in areas that tourists and foreigners frequent. These areas include the area within the moat, the walking street, the night bazaar, Wallai, walking street, Ching Jay Market, and Loi Kro. So just keep your personal belongings close to you, especially when you're going to crowded and busy areas in the city. Driving in the city can be stressful if you're on the bike because of too much traffic, but part of the problem is that road laws are rarely respected here. There's drink driving, speeding, and riding a motorcycle without a helmet, but otherwise the crime rate in Chiang Mai is quite low considering it's a big city.
Overall, if you plan to live here in Chiang Mai, it's relatively safe. And, you know, just be aware of your surroundings and just apply your street smarts and you'll be okay. In Chiang Mai, there are many communities and groups depending on your interests. And you can join those groups so you don't feel alone or you can meet new friends. For example, if you like yoga or meditation, then there's a Chiang Mai Conscious Community. There's yoga in the park, there's Chiang Mai meditation group, and so on.
When we moved to Chiang Mai, I joined a few Facebook groups relevant to my interests, such as Nature in Chiang Mai, Chiang Mai Nomad Girls for meetups and events, Chiang Mai Conscious Community for yoga, meditation, and other similar activities, Chiang Mai Eats for restaurants and cafes in the city, and many more. There are also cooking classes, bird watching tours, dancing, glamping, hiking groups, language exchange meetups, business-related meetups, fitness activities, and many more here in Chiang Mai. If you have young kids, there are different activities available for them to socialize with other children and to explore their new skills, such as the theater, dancing, art, yoga, football, martial arts. When my son was here, I enrolled him in martial arts class for twice a week sessions and he loved it a lot. And of course, there are so many night markets, farmers markets, festivals, and many of these are in Chiang Mai cities, such as at Wan Niman, Jingjay, Night Bazaar. I created a PDF of some of my recommended restaurants, cafes, glamping, camping sites, cooking classes, meditation retreats, spas, bike rentals, and so on here in Chiang Mai. I shared the link to this PDF in the description box below, and this may be helpful for you when you come here. Now let's talk about housing options here in Chiang Mai. I have been asked so many times, where should I live or how can I find a place to rent? And so I would like to address these questions in today's video. So it actually depends on your interest or your preference. If you don't have your own vehicle and you're not planning on getting your own motorcycle or car, then living in the city would be easier because of accessibility to public transport. But of course, if you prefer to live in the city, then there are some drawbacks to that. In the city, it's more crowded, traffic is heavier, and if you like nature or to live somewhere out in nature, then you can't do that when you're in the city. There are parks, but then, you know, it's not the same as living in, you know, the countryside. Now, if you would like to live in the countryside, of course, the pros would be it's quieter and traffic is lighter, and of course, you know, you're closer to nature. But at the same time, there are some drawbacks. If you don't have your own transportation, then it will be harder.
If you're living in Chiang Mai longer than a month, it is better to have your own vehicle, whether it's a motorcycle, a scooter, or a car. This gives you more mobility, especially if you live in a place that has no easy access to public transportation. Plus, renting a car or a motorcycle for a long time or taking the taxi end up being more expensive anyway than having your own vehicle. It's more costly upfront, but you can save more time, especially when you plan to stay longer. And personally, we enjoy exploring Chiang Mai's countryside on a motorcycle, and we have discovered some of our favorite scenic drives and cafes by just driving around and taking new routes and exploring off the beaten paths.
And then another thing to consider is that the more rural you are, the farther away you are from the city, the less locals can speak in English. So it really helps to be able to converse with locals in the Thai language. Now, if you prefer to live in a place that has a more rural feel, then that would be Doi Saket, Mei Rim, Sarafi, San Kampeng.
In these areas, traffic is lighter, you'll see more rice fields and mountain views. It is quieter and there are quaint cafes and restaurants with scenic views. But one thing to note is that since there are many rice fields here, after the harvest season, it can get pretty smoky in these areas when farmers burn the fields to prepare it for the next planting season. We actually just moved to Doi Saket last month and we like it here so far. Some of the places we visited include the Mei Kwang Udom Tara Dam, Wat Pratat Doi Saket, the viewpoint, a few viewpoints, and some cafes. We plan on exploring Doi Saket more and I'll share with you the places we visited soon. We lived in Heng Dong for 3 years and we liked it. We particularly loved the ride to Nam Pre and discovering new cafes and trails there. Some of our favorite places in Heng Dong are Ob Khan National Park, the Heritage House and Garden, and we also stayed in one of their cottages for my birthday last year, Lana Rock Garden, Jungle de Cafe, Din Cafe, the White Pagoda in Banpong, Hillsboro, and just so many beautiful cafes, restaurants, and scenic areas. Now, rent is relatively cheap here in Chiang Mai. For example, the house that we are renting right now, it costs 13,000 Thai baht. So there are two bedrooms, two bathrooms, kitchen, living room, and then there's, you know, it's fully furnished. It's got everything we need. The only thing we had to get before we moved in was internet. So we got a 3BB. So we got a 3BB broadband internet plan, which is also very cheap. And then water is also cheap. And then for electric, it's cheaper, of course, in the cooler months. Like, for example, we just paid our electric bill. It costs 2,700 plus Thai baht. So that's for the month of, so that's from November 19th to December 19th. And we were not really using the AC that much, but we were using the electric oven almost every day for a few hours. And also we have an electric pressure cooker. And then in the summer, we average around 3,500 to 4,000 Thai baht. Overall, I like living here in Chiang Mai. Even if it's a big city, there are many places outside of the city center where you can be closer to nature, where it's quieter, and where the traffic is just lighter. So, for just like the places that I mentioned earlier, Doi Saket, Mei Rim, San Kampeng, yeah, Sarafi. And then there are also areas that are not exactly in the city center but not super far from it, so it's also accessible, such as in Hang Dong or in San Sai and a few other locations. I also like the fact that I feel safe here, and there are many activities and communities that are relevant to my interests, so that those are other plus points to living here in Chiang Mai. Now, at the beginning of this video, I mentioned that I will talk about two other locations that I love here in Thailand, and one of them is Koh Lanta. We have been there twice and we really love that place because of the small town feel, and you know, it's in the south, so there's a beach.
We also love Chiang Dao. It's in Chiang Mai province, and we love the laid-back energy there, stress-free driving because of very light traffic, gorgeous nature, and very friendly locals. It's ideal for people who like to live far from the city and can be content with a simple rural life. Life in Chiang Mai has its ups and downs, and some days may be better than others, but that's just how it is no matter where in the world you live. But personally, I like living here because of the overall relaxed and laid-back energy. And many things here just resonate with me.
So that's all that I have to share for today. Let me know in the comments what you think of this video. Share. I look forward to hearing from you what your favorite places are here in Chiang Mai or how you feel about the city. So thank you again for watching. I hope you learned something valuable today. Don't forget to check the links down below for resources on the topics that I mentioned, such as the different interest-based groups and communities here in Chiang Mai, as well as, you know, the different housing options and just some helpful tips that should come in handy should you decide to live here. So thank you so much again for watching this video. I look forward to seeing you again next week, and have a wonderful day.